Hello students, today I am going to solve the numericals on lumped system analysis. Lumped system analysis means here it is a transient heat transfer where the internal temperature gradients are negligible or internal temperature resistance, internal thermal resistance are negligible. Okay, in that one, okay, whether we are going to apply the lumped system analysis for the transient heat transfer or we can go for the use of transient temperature charts. First I am going to solve the some numericals on the lumped system analysis where the internal temperature gradients are negligible. Okay, on that one, the first problem is that a 12 centimeter diameter long bar initially at a uniform temperature of 40 degrees Celsius is placed in a medium at 650 degrees Celsius with a convective coefficient H is equal to 22 watt per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the time required for the bar to reach 255 degrees Celsius temperature. Take K is equal to 20 watt per meter Kelvin, rho is equal to 580 kg per meter cube, Cp is equal to 1.05 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Now firstly, we have to write the given data. As the diameter is given, 12 centimeter, and we can find out the radius from that one, but it's 0.12 meter, that is R is equal to 0.06 meter. T naught is the initial temperature 40 degrees Celsius, medium temperature 650 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient 22 watt per meter square Kelvin, thermal conductivity 20 watt per meter Kelvin, Cp 1.05 kilojoule per kg Kelvin or 1.05 into 10 raised to 3 joule per kg Kelvin, rho density 58 kg per meter cube, and temperature after particular time is 255 degrees Celsius. In this transient heat transfer problems, first thing we have to find out the Biot number. Based on Biot number, we can decide whether it is a lumped system analysis is applicable or we have to go for use of transient temperature charts. Okay, if the Biot number is less than 0.1, we have to use the lumped system analysis, and if it is more than 0.1, we have to go for use of transient temperature charts. Now that this is, if it is less than 0.1, then only it will give the correct result, that is the lumped system analysis temperature distribution equation. Okay, within the 5% error it will give. And also sometimes even though it is less than 0.1, then we have to go for the transient temperature charts. Because of that one, that time the temperature at a particular distance if it's asked, then we have to go for the that use of transient temperature charts. Here we are neglecting that which the temperature distribution, whatever the variation with respect to distance, that is a uniform temperature distribution throughout the solid we are considering for the lumped system analysis. Then for finding the Biot number is HLC by K, that is characteristic length, that is R we got, that is R by 2, it is for the cylinder. Okay, L by 2 for the slab, R by 2 for the cylinder, and it is R by 3 for the sphere. Then Biot number BI is given as H 22, that is LC 0.06 by 2, 20.033. is less than 0.1. Then so lumped system analysis is applicable. Lumped system analysis temperature distribution, we know that is theta of T by theta naught, theta of T of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity is equal to e raised to minus HAT by rho CPV. Already we know this equation. Then this equation can be rearranged by taking this expansion term this side, that is the ln of T of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity is equal to minus HAT by rho CPV. Okay, here this equation by substituting the temperature terms 255 minus 650 by 40 minus 650, that is equal to HAT by rho CP V by A. This is rearranged, that is V by A is taken. V by A is a R by 2 for the cylinder. Then R by 2 is taken here. R by 2, the 2 is taken in the numerator, there is a minus 2 HT by rho CPR. Minus 2 into 22 into T by 580 into 1050, that is a CP and 0.06 radius. After finding this one, Okay, after calculating, we will get that time 360.89 or 360.9 degrees Celsius, 9 second or 6 minute and 1 second for reaching the temperature to 255 degrees Celsius. Then another condition here for the lumped system analysis system, for a mixed boundary condition we can use. The internal temperature gradients are negligible, but boundary conditions are mixed. One side is having one surface is having the one boundary condition, another surface is having the another boundary condition. For this, the whatever the derivation is there, that is not there for our syllabus, but the final equation is used for finding the some numericals, solving the some numericals by using this mixed boundary condition. That is a theta of t minus is equal to t theta naught e raised to minus mt plus of 1 minus e raised to minus mt into q by h. Q is the heat flux. The finding the heat flux for the mixed boundary condition, we can use this one. Okay, or temperature distribution also sometimes we can find from this one. The second numerical, that is a steel ball of 50 millimeter diameter and 900 degrees Celsius temperature, placed in a steel temperature of 30 degrees Celsius atmospheric conditions. Calculate the initial rate of cooling of the ball in degree Celsius per minute. Take rho is equal to 7800 kg per meter cube, Cp 2 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, H 30 watt per meter square Kelvin. Neglect internal thermal resistance. Okay, here directly they have mentioned that is internal thermal resistance we have to neglect. That's a lumped system analysis directly we can apply. It's not necessary to find out the Biot number here. Directly we can go for the, there is a use of lumped system analysis. Writing the given data, the initial temperature is 900 degrees Celsius, medium temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, and diameter is 50 mm, that is 0.05 meter, and radius we can find out from that one. H is 30 watt per meter square Kelvin. Then rho is 7800 kg per meter cube, Cp 2 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Okay, that we can use. And lumped system analysis equation, already temperature distribution equation, we have this one. The theta of t by theta naught, t of t minus t infinity by t naught minus t infinity is equal to e raised to minus mt. And here the steel ball, it is a sphere. The sphere problem, it means for the sphere problem, where the phi by a characteristic length is there, that is different. M is equal to ha by rho cp phi, h by rho cp into characteristic length L, then L will be the calculated here, V by A, that V by A is equal to R by 3. Okay, R by 3, this is 8.33 into 10 raised to minus 6, minus 3 meter we got here. And that if we substitute here LC, then we are going to get the M 2.308 into 10 raised to minus 4. Then after substituting the M, okay, here the T of T will find out. For the 1 minute, for 1 minute, how much cooling will be there? Okay, then rate of cooling from that one we can find out. Okay, here the T of T will find out after 1 minute, means 60 seconds. That is T of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity is equal to e raised to mt. Okay, T is 60 degrees Celsius. Then T of T is unknown, the all other terms we know. Then T of T we got here after the simplification 188 degrees Celsius. Then rate of cooling will be the initial temperature minus one temperature after 1 minute by temperature. Temperature after 1 minute. Okay, what is there? 880 degrees Celsius by its time 1 minute. 12 degrees Celsius per minute, the rate of cooling we got here. The another problem, somewhat different numerical here, that is a 12 millimeter diameter steel sphere, directly sphere is mentioned, K is equal to 42.5 watt per meter Kelvin, is placed in an air stream at 27 degrees Celsius, and the corresponding heat transfer coefficient is 114 watt per meter square Kelvin. Calculate first one, time taken to cool the sphere from 540 degrees Celsius to 95 degrees Celsius. Then instantaneous heat transfer rate 2 minutes after the commencement of the cooling. Take rho is equal to 7850 kg per meter cube, Cp 475 joule per kg Kelvin, alpha 0.043 meter square per hour. First, we'll write the given data. T naught is equal to 540 degrees Celsius, T of T 95 degrees Celsius. For that, we have to find out the time. Medium temperature T infinite 27 degrees Celsius, H is equal to 114 watt per meter square Kelvin, K is equal to 42.5 watt per meter Kelvin, R is 0.006 meter, alpha is 0.043 meter square per hour, meter square per second we have to take, and later we will change this one. The first one, time taken to cool the sphere from 540 degrees Celsius to 95 degrees Celsius. Find the characteristic length LC, V by A, that is R by 3 for the sphere, the R by 3 is 0.002 meter. Then M we can find out, H by HA by rho Cp phi actually, H by rho Cp LC, that is V by A, it is there. Then substituting this one, the H rho Cp phi, then that is LC, then we can find out this as a M. Then biot number HLC by K, this is HLC by K. (5.36 × 10⁻³) less than 0.1. Then lumped system analysis is applicable. Okay, as it is less than 0.1, lumped system analysis is applicable. Then we'll use the temperature distribution equation for the lumped system analysis. That is a T of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity is equal to e raised to minus mt. Then 95 − 27 / 540 − 27, that is equal to e raised to minus m, already m we determined, that into t we will find out. The t is 132.1 second. To cool the sphere from 542 degrees Celsius to 95 degrees Celsius, 132.1 second time is required. Then second one, instantaneous heat transfer rate after 2 minutes. Okay, this is the instantaneous heat transfer rate, Qi is equal to minus Ha T naught minus T infinity into e raised to minus Bi F naught. Minus Ha T naught minus T infinity e raised to minus Mt. Here either we can find out the Biot number and Fourier number separately and we can substitute in this equation, or we can find out the M and multiplication of T, we can substitute in this equation. Here the surface area of the sphere 4 pi r square, then this will get alpha is this one, okay, point divided by 0.043 divided by 3600. Okay, here Fourier Biot number is already we got, we determined 5.36 × 10⁻³. Fourier number is alpha t by LC square. Then this is 0.043 into 120 by this 3600 × 0.002 square. Then 358.33 we get. Then instantaneous heat transfer will be this one, after substituting this all terms, this 122 minutes after this one. The time always we have to take in terms of the second CR. Then instantaneous heat transfer will be the 4.215 watt. Then total heat transfer rate in this problem is not asked, but we can find out that also, as it is very close, similar to that as instantaneous heat transfer. Then rho Cp phi T naught minus T infinity e raised to minus Biot number into Fourier number minus 1. This is Mt also we can write. Okay. Then here substitute rho Cp phi T naught minus T infinity e raised to Mt 120, that is 2 minutes. And for that we get here minus 1454.61 or 1.573. The similar answers we got here. Okay, these are the different lumped system analysis problems. We will go for the some other numericals on this use of transient temperature charts later, and you solve the some numericals on some other numericals on the this lumped system analysis. Thank you.